So today we're going to go back in time. We're going to go back to Camtasia Studio 8. A student reached out to me and was like, hey, I need to be able to do this thing using Camtasia Studio 8. Is it even possible? And I'm going to show you how I would go through and do this. This is probably the last Camtasia 8 video that I'll do, only because TechSmith stopped supporting Camtasia 8 a long time ago. I hope you enjoy. So the question is, I would like to know if a certain type of animations, like the pop-ups in the following video, can be done with Camtasia Studio 8, and if so, show me how to do this. And so for the benefit of everybody, let me show you a little snippet of the video. So here's the video, I'm gonna go ahead and play it, and there are a couple of pop-ups that they use. So there's the first, you saw this circle pop-up, there's another one here, where it shows, you know, text behind a box, and I'm gonna try and recreate both of these, both the circle and this lower thirds. So here we are back in Camtasia Studio 8. So we're going to assume that we have a video, some sort of video in the background. So I'm gonna grab this animated title and I'm gonna drag this down to track one. We're going to assume that this is some person talking back here. And what we wanna do is add a couple things. So let's start by adding a callout. And what that person added was a circle callout. So I'm gonna grab that circle callout. And that's just about the right size. I mean, we can resize it a little bit. Remember, if we resize and grab that corner that we can distort, we don't want that. So I will control Z to undo that. So I'm gonna use the control key and now it keeps it as a perfect circle. So that's great. I'll find the size I want. Let's say it's that. I don't know what it was originally, but here's the first thing. So we want this to appear at some point a little later. Now with this, let's zoom in. And what I think this person is doing, let's, you know, make this a little longer, is it looked like it kind of popped up and did like a grow and shrink kind of thing. So what I'm gonna do is have this selected and then I'm gonna go to the visual properties. And what we wanna do is add an animation. So this first animation, it's fairly quick. I'm gonna make it like 10 frames. We're gonna make it right at the beginning. So we're gonna start with it all the way at the beginning. And at this point, with the visual properties, I'm going to go and we're gonna say the scale, let's, you know, do something like 80% or 85, 90. Okay, so that's 88%, sure. So we'll start at 88% and then it grows up to like 109. And then I'm gonna add another animation and then I'm gonna bring it to like 100. Okay, so let's just play through that. So it appears, goes big and then small. There we go. So there's like a little bounce. And if you wanted to do even another, like it goes down and then I think it even comes back up. Let's add one more, another annotation or animation on this item. So we'll add another animation and we'll make it go up to like 105. Something like that. So now it goes, let's play through it. Yeah, so it kind of pops in and does this bounce thing. Another thing I think it might do is maybe start invisible. So let's maybe try and drop the opacity to zero and play that. There we go. So it fades in and then does this little bounce thing. Okay, so that's the first part. Then after that's there, there's some kind of text. Well, that's a call out. I need to add an annotation. So let's add the call out first. All right, so now we have this call out. Good, here it is. Let's look at the visual properties. Opacity's kind of low. Let's bring that opacity all the way up. And then let's go back to the callout and I'm gonna do control A in here to select it all. And the text I think is a white text that they use and it's a cleaner font. Let's just use Arial. Arial will be a good clean font for us. The other thing is we wanna center it. And then we also want to make it a size that'll fit in there. So 28 points, probably bigger than that, 36. And remember you can enter the exact number you want. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna make this aligned with the exact size of the circle itself. So let's do that. There we go. So now it's perfectly in the center. And then what this person does is they just, you know, they have this thing pop up and then text comes in. If we go to the callouts, I think another thing they do is with the circle, they have a little bit more of a border on it. So what we can do is go to the border. I don't remember what color they had. Let's say it's a white border. And we want probably the thickness to be bigger, right? To make it really stand out. Another thing you can see here is it's a little lighter at the top. There's this style that exists. And if you want it to be more consistent, you can choose that style. That's the third style. At the end of this, you probably want it to fade out. You probably want everything to fade out at the same time. So I don't know how long this will be on here, but I would align all of these fade outs to be the same duration or at the same time, something like that. And then they'll all kind of fade out together. And then we could have something else pop up. So the other thing we would have pop up is this rectangle. So I'm going to add a call out, and that call out is going to be this rectangle. And it looked like there was just an info box down here. What I would do is I would start with this actually off the screen. So if I use the scroll wheel on my mouse and scroll down, I can get this to start off the screen. Maybe I want it, you know, like here, right? Just off screen. And then what I'll do is I'll come in here and I'll add an animation. So I'll come in a little bit, go to visual properties, add an animation, make it, you know, like I said, closer to 10 frames. And here I want it to pop up to this point or maybe a little bit further. All right. And then I want text to appear over top of it. Now, if you want, I think you can do grouping here. Well, you know how to add a text call out. Let me just show you. We would come in here. We would say add another call out. We would make it a text call out. Where's my text? Oh, there it was. Text call out. And then, you know, put whatever information is on here. If you wanted to make it your own, you know, if you're introducing yourself, Control A, Ron Hogue, and then, you know, technical trainer, maybe a capital T on both. Something like that. And we'd need to make that a little longer. So you could put something like that. She also has like a circle off to the side. So if you wanted to, you could combine some of these together. And if we go up here, we can, you know, add another call out. Let's do that. And like I said, I think she has a circle, and you know, it's something like over here. It's a little bit larger than the rest of it. So something like that. So that could appear all at the same time, but if we wanted to, I'm going to try this. I'm going to try deleting that animation, grab all of these here together, make them all start at the same point, grab both of these, have them down here as well. And then I'm going to try and group these. So Control G to group. Yep. So now they're all grouped together, and then I can add an animation here. So we'll go to visual properties, add an animation, and we're going to shorten it to 10 frames, and we're just going to move it up. So now if I play through this, you have the whole thing pop up. Now it looks like I didn't leave quite enough room there on technical trainer, but I, you know, you get the idea. Really all I would need to do is select this text, make it a little bit smaller. So what is it now? 36. You know, maybe I would make it 32. You know, move it up to here, right? Pops up. And then what I would do is I would add an animation before it all ends to have it go away at the same time. So I would go back here, you know, some point later, whenever I want it to disappear, click on this. I would add another animation. And again, shorten that duration, and then just have it drop down here. So then I play through, my name comes up, things are going on in the background, and when I'm done, have it disappear. I'm going to try one more thing. I'm not even sure if you can do this in Camtasia 8, but I think part of what she had at one point was a semi-transparent background. So you were able to see through the background a little bit. So I'm going to drop that transparency. There we go. You look here, you can see the bubbles a little bit behind. So it's semi-transparent. I think that looks pretty professional when you have that little bit of semi-transparency behind it. So you can see I added, you know, I went to just that one rectangle. I just said, let's make the opacity, you know, somewhere around 2/3. And then, like I said, you can see what's going on behind it. That is the way that I would go about creating these two kinds of pop-ups using Camtasia 8. I hope this was fun for you. It was fun for me. I honestly spent a whole lot more time trying to figure out how to get Camtasia 8 on my computer than I did working on the problem itself. But a little bit fun to go down memory lane and revisit this. And if you have other questions, feel free to leave a comment below and let me know what it is you're trying to do. Hopefully you're using Camtasia 2020. It's so much faster. It's so much easier to do these things, but still not too difficult to do them in Camtasia Studio version 8 that is no longer supported by TechSmith. So Hope that was helpful. Thanks so much for watching. So long.